those hips, pushing up and pushing against that wall with your feet, and then coming back down. But I want you to push your knees together really tightly and thinking about all of your thighs, not allowing any light through. Parallel, out, in, two more sets. Parallel, toes out, toes in, last set. You're still squeezing that glute, and this other leg is really just getting a nice stretch through the hamstrings. Push, this time you're pushing your toes into the wall. Squeezing those glutes, keep going. Okay, so usually we have the leg out in front a little bit, but this time we're starting in that perfect parallel position. Up, sweep, back. Front, back. Knee and really straighten out each time whilst keeping your leg up. Direction, because we're going to go the other way. It should be feeling a bit shaky now. If not, then you need to wear some ankle weights next time. And press away. Just a little exercise to get the blood flowing again before we move on to that other side. Let's bring your heels up, stretching away, and pressure against those heels. Flexed feet. Keeping that leg perfectly straight up and down each time. So you're squeezing that entire leg and moving it as one unit, tapping the wall. Even on the front there, tiny little graze. It's not a really far action, you're just coming forward a little tiny way and then to the back. Imagine there's an imaginary line on that wall that your foot is going back and forth on, so don't let it drop. In and out. Try to keep the leg up. Point up. Toe, tap the wall with your toe. And you're coming in at a diagonal. You're pointing the toe on the wall each time and then bringing your foot down parallel and no burns. Remember, you can always lay down here if you're releasing the tension out of that shoulder. 8, 7, 6, 5. Toe, heel. Keep going. Lots of reps. You're just pushing away a tiny bit from that wall, pressing into the palm of your hand and hovering your hips off the ground just a tiny bit. 3, 2, 1. Now bring your hands by your side and we're going to reach back and forward. So each time I want you to slide those palms up the wall. Now want your arms up at 90 and we're going to start coming in and back, doing a bicep curl. 3, 2, 1. Now hold it up and knock your elbows together. That wall, going in this direction for a little bit longer and then we're gonna change. Straighten your arms. Should feel this in the front of your shoulders. Keep going. 8. So in, keep your elbows down, out, and chest. Your arm up at shoulder height, in and out. There's not much happening here, but you're really holding everything in strongly, pulling that belly button in towards your spine. Legs up, and it's a tiny crunch towards that straight leg. So you're reaching forward slightly. You're leaning back each time as far as you can. The more you lean back, the more you're gonna engage those upper abs, okay? So we're gonna do 4, 4, 2, 2, and then singles. We'll go straight into it. So 1, 2, center, wide, center, up and down, up and down, down, up, push up, tap it down, up, push up, and tap the body. So if you want to come down even further, you can. So even just holding this should be quite challenging. Now what we're going to do is tap down, up with our legs, out, in, down, up. Out, in, down, up. and you're just sliding your back against that wall. Yeah? But if you can, keep those feet up. Not many, I know it's tough. Start again. Straight legs and tap.